Hello, everybody, and welcome to HD Piano. My name is Dan. In this lesson, we'll learn how to play Let It Go by James Bay. We're going to take a look at the intro and verse. That much sounds like this. 2, 3, 4. So that's the intro and verse to Let It Go by James Bay. The rest of the sections, pre-chorus, chorus, bridge, whole song run-through, all that is at hdpiano.com, so head that way when you're done here. And as usual, a quick question before we get going. What is your favorite James Bay song? This is the first one of his in our library, so we'd like to know what else you might like, or is this your favorite? Comment below. All right, let's get going on this intro. The good news about this intro and verse is that the left hand doesn't change. It loops the same thing throughout, and that is this. D flat and A flat, up to G flat and D flat. You'll notice this is the same shape, these are fifths. Down to B flat and F, and then the final chord of the series has us just dropping that low note down to A flat. This is a sixth. But those four chords are what repeat and make up this entire intro and verse. So again, it's D flat and B and A flat, G flat and D flat, B flat and F, and A flat and F. And on these chords, on these two notes, we play alternating, this alternating rhythm. And the rhythm is a little bit tricky, in that we're anticipating every other chord. So we play 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So every other chord is introduced on the fourth beat. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's try just that much, the left hand, slowly. 1 and 2 and ready and play. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1 and 2, 3. Repeat. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2. Ready and stop. Okay, so get comfortable making those chord changes and playing that rhythm in the left hand. That's going to guide a lot of this song, that left-hand part, and it's not going to vary too much for the rest of the sections. So let's learn it well. Let's pick up the speed on it. Same thing, a little faster. 1 and 2 and ready and play. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you can't play it at that speed, rewind, try it again, memorize it, practice it at your own pace. Because here we go, this is close to studio tempo, which is 150. 1, 2, ready. And 1, 2, and 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
All right. So that's the left hand. That covers the entire intro and verse of the left hand. Let's look at the right hand by itself. I'll play the hands together so you can be reminded of what this sounds like. All right. So we have F, G flat, D flat. And then it comes right back down. The next two notes of the melody are C, D flat, and then D flat, F, B flat, So that is phrase number one of the intro. Again. Okay. With the left hand, it sounds like this. Notice that last note kind of waits a little bit. Okay, you notice the second time, we don't play B flat to A flat, we just play A flat and we hold through. So I'm gonna play the entire intro really, really slowly. Use this as your guideline. Here we go. Two and ready and play. It's much easier, faster, so let's take it at a medium tempo. One and two and ready and play. And at recorded tempo, 150. One, two, ready, and. Okay, work that intro up to your speed at your own comfort pace, okay, your comfortable pace. Now is the verse. This is easier than the intro, and it involves most of the same pieces. So here's what it sounds like. One, two, ready, go. So the right hand, left hand is playing the same thing, like I initially mentioned. Right hand is just playing these single note sort of supporting roles. And again, this is, I may not have mentioned this actually, this is a guitar-based song, if that wasn't obvious. So we're doing a lot of condensing, a lot of arranging of that guitar part, guitar parts, I believe there are two, into one piano part. So keep that in mind. If you're like, this doesn't sound like this song, that's why. we're playing it on a different instrument. Okay, so let's take a look at the right hand, because that's the only thing that changes here. We're playing 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we play 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's easy enough, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we play 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's the more challenging part. It's the second half is 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so slowly the whole verse is this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's loop that. Two, three, four. One, two, three, last time. It's kind of hard at a slow tempo because of those anticipations, every other chord sort of being anticipated a whole beat ahead of what we're familiar with as downbeats. It's hard at a slow tempo. It might shift us a little bit around. But let's play it at a medium tempo. One and two and ready and play. Here's one thing I needed to mention too. The accompaniment changes the very last time we play this. So we play this same thing three times. After the third time, we change. It's very subtle. This is what it is on the fourth time. So instead of going to A flat, we just settle on this E flat in the right hand. Okay? All right, at this point, I think I've given you everything you need for the intro and verse, but we really haven't played it together cohesively. So, intro and verse, super slow. One and two and ready and play. Pre-chorus. All right, let's play it at recorded tempo and then we can move on. Here we go. Intro, verse, one, two, ready, and. So that's it. We're learning Let It Go by James Bay. My name's Dan here at HD Piano. Like I said before, hdpiano.com is where we'll finish this lesson. We have the pre-chorus and chorus section, we have the bridge, and we have the whole song. And that will complete the entire lesson at hdpiano.com. Well, I've got you on the line. Why don't we connect on social media? On Twitter, we'll take your requests. Hashtag HDRequests. We are at HDPiano. We get a ton of requests. Browse that hashtag to see what's coming through. Add your own to the list. On Instagram, we would love to see what you're doing performance-wise. Send us a performance clip, and we will repost it to our followers at HDPiano. You can just tag us in your video. We will repost. On Facebook, a thumbs up is always nice. On YouTube, that little red rectangle is calling you out to subscribe. So subscribe, and let's just stay in touch, guys. We love hearing from you. And part two to Let It Go is next at hdpiano.com, the home of the hybrid piano lesson. I'm Dan, and I'll see you there.